and stopped, you know, basically they stopped. They shut everything down for a while until now they started getting back the whole thing. But what happened was that I had a whole bunch of illustrations that I had worked on, and they wanted to keep, they wanted to have...
What, illustrations you did?
Yeah, they wanted to have at least 20, 30 illustrations of mine, you know, just sitting there for one day to have it as an investment, you know?
How many did you give them?
So I had six of them. And when I saw that things were doing bad, you know, I told the guys, I said, listen, you know what, you guys are having problems and whatnot. You know what, I'm going to go ahead and move this on my own. And that's when I went and I sent them to, I proposed them to Robert. Robert told me, it's money in the bank. You know, I don't have a problem moving this ones. You know, I love them and this and that, blah, 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 whatever. Make a story short. We're now in July. It's been already out actually 3 months and a half. I haven't seen one dime, okay?
And they have the, who have paintings now?
Robert.
Robert Vane?
Robert Vane has them.
Shit, man.
That's what I'm telling you.
You shouldn't have dealt with him at all, man. He fucking folded up shop. I told him he was going to fold shop last October.
Man,
and sure enough.
He didn't even tell me. I found out he actually done it. Even after he was already out of there, even after he was already out, you know, he still told me he was still there in business and whatnot.
Yeah, he's lying. And then he starts talking shit about everybody that was there.
About everybody. Dude. Everyone. Let me tell you, Drew, it was so painful to me. Because, again, I'm telling you, I heard a lot of stories from other illustrators, you know.
Yeah, and that's what I was trying to...
He owes money to Pete. He owes money to so many different people. And he actually never did it to me. But not only that, but then also to hear that he was talking shit.
He talked more shit when I told him, because I told him, I don't want anything to do with your gallery anymore. You know, I don't want anything to do with it. And he's like, why not? I'm like, look. You know, you're not the same company. I see the writing on the wall. You're going down. And he didn't like it. He got all hurt and offended and everything. And he goes, yeah. What artist don't you like? I'm like, I didn't say he didn't like any artists. It's just not the same company. You know, it was just Olivia, Toriyama, Gerardo, and it was real small. Now you got a shitload of everybody. And he goes, dude, I know who it is. You know, I know who it is. I know what the big stink is. I was like, what? And he's like, oh, well, I don't want to mention names, but there's been a big stink about this and that. And I knew he was talking about you, man.
Yeah.
And he was talking about you. And then he mentioned some other guy named Armando.
Yeah.
Whatever his name is. I don't know. But anyway. Yeah,
he can pin that shit on me, man. He can pin that shit on me. He knows.
Because I heard some rumors too from him. Because he was talking shit, and I was like, "What are you talking about?" And he didn't really want to talk about it. So then I was like talking. Well, who did I talk to? Mobius, and then I talked to somebody else, and they're like, "Yeah, there's some big stink about, you know, some sticker company and some other bullshit. I don't know what they're talking about, but
What?
I don't know what the hell, but somebody was saying, this is what I wanted. Yeah. They were saying he didn't pick the shit, and I was like. Why would he, and then they're saying shit like, they got some other, like, artist putting somebody else's signature over yours and shit?
Yeah. Listen, man, it's a funny thing that,
they're trying to fuck you over, man, it sounds like.
Big time, I got attorneys that ran out of working through this whole entire thing. I got attorneys that have been working in this for forever, and at the beginning, Robert was pushing at it. He was backing me before I sent them all these illustrations, and, you know, and then I guess he used that on himself to then come back to me and say, you know, say to me, well, but I don't understand what's going on and what.
Oh, so he was making that up so he could have a way out.
You know what? He knows that he cannot do that. And you know why he can't do that?
What?
Because before I worked with anyone, worked under me as a finisher, and the reason that I started using a finisher was because when I didn't sign an exclusive with Robert Vane, and I saw that it was a market where one day you were making X amount of money, but the next month you didn't know if you were going to get a secure paycheck or not.
Right, so you got to pump it out.
Yeah, you know, and I spoke with, you know, and Johnny Loa, you know, which he was my former publisher, you know, John said to me, man, you know what? You know, we can hire, you know, like two or three different finishers and illustrators. And Ricky, let's just move as many paintings as we can. I remember that I talked to a number of artists, you know, and everybody was like, yeah, man, you know what I mean? Business is business. Fuck it, you know, whatever. And Armando, he was my finisher, man. He was my finisher before Armando existed.
Oh, so
are you aware of this? Armando, and the industry knows this. People that know me,
right,
they know that, man, I've been in the business for 15 years.
Right.
Before anybody else existed, you know, I was already there, and I was already doing my airbrush. And when I was at nobody, when I was just getting started and everything, I won the fucking, gold award in New York City and everything, you know, for doing airbrushing there live, you know, in visual arts. You know, and everybody knows that. Robert Vane knows that, you know. But aside from that, Robert Vane, you know, he called me up and he said to me, that, you know, Sandy, which is a fatal attraction bitch, she's the one that created this whole thing.
Who? Whoa, 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 who are you talking about?
Sandy from Stickit.com. She's the one that created this whole entire thing. You know, let me tell you something.
She created what? She
created this whole entire bullshit on the internet about me, about Armando being the real artist and about me being fake and a fraud and everything. And
stuff does she own like the company or something?
She owns the company. And what happened was she was already dealing with John, and she knew that I had working in the company. We had three different illustrators. And they were working.
So you're kind of like an illustration house almost.
I opened up a studio. Robert knew this.
So is this good, or is he just like, is he suck?
No, he is. He is great.
He is great.
He was,
really?
Let me tell you something, man. He was not only my right hand, but he became my best friend. And he broke my fucking heart. He broke mine and the heart of my family.
How?
We let him in as my brother, as a brother that I never
remember. How do you do? He just, what, slip over your name?
Man, he fucking sold out. He sold. Look, I went ahead and I did a licensing deal with Andy for the stickers.
The bitch that was doing
but what happened was is that Sandy's a kettle, you know, she's a fatal attraction bimbo.
Okay, so she started out cool, then turned into a bitch or something, or
we had something going there.
And
the wrong pussy that you shouldn't fuck. Then I went ahead and got a deal with Netsales, which is our biggest competitor.
See, that's somebody, they've been emailing me, Netsales, some woman named Robin Lamont, yeah.
Yes, you talk to Robin, and you tell Robin that you know me, and that we go way back and everything, and Robin is going to tell you.
She'll hook me up?
They're great. Cool. And they're the leading company. But
yeah, she seemed real friendly. I didn't like their website that much, though. But
no, their website is very, very simple, but they do have a huge clientele, let me tell you.
Yeah.
They're great.
Yeah, that seemed pretty cool.
So, you know, make a long story short, I went ahead and I did a licensing deal with NetSales. Since I was not exclusive with Sandy, and I already knew Sandy was a fuck-up, and everybody told me...
And did you do the deal?
Carlos told me from day one, man... Be careful. I already have my problems and whatnot. And even Carlos at the end then turned on me because Carlos knew everything that was going on. And then when I told Hannah that I called on the phone and I told Hannah, I told him, Carlos, can you believe that Sandy's turning around and doing this? She found my finisher over there in California because we had a falling out, you know.
So she stole your finisher or something?
I don't know how she found them. She found them. They went fucking head and told them, listen. And the bottom line is that if you work some of the images, you own some of the images. What happened was that when I called Sandy, and I told Sandy, Sandy, this is nothing personal. We have a licensing deal, but since I remember that I told you it was not exclusive with no one, because I don't have signed an exclusive with anybody, I went ahead and I did a licensing deal with NetSales. I wasn't even finished with the word, and she exploded. She blew up. She went crazy, you know, because that's her computer. That's her competitor.
Right, yeah.
You know, and he got out of hand, man. And I told him, well, you know what? If you don't want to deal with it, you know what? I mean, because I told you that I was non-exclusive. And the reason that I told you that it was non-exclusive, it was just the same thing.
Right.
If you're going to pay me the same thing that these people are offering to pay, guess what? You know, but I got to pay bills, man. I got two kids that you got to feed.
Right.
You know, it's the bottom line. So whatever.
So that's okay.
She just went crazy. She started posting all kinds of garbage and shit.
Right. Oh, really? Slandering you and shit? And like
talking? She's got a whole bunch of shit. You know, and everything and stuff like that. And then since I had at that time sold my license, visual images.
You're shitting
you know,
me.
Huh?
You're shitting me, really?
No, man. It was out of hand. But then the guy from Visual Images told me, hey, man, you know, if you get into a legal suit right now, do you think that we're ever going to be able to bring any investors to invest into your name into the new company that we're forming down here?
Right. That's true. They got to keep your name out of that shit.
They got to keep the name out of it. So you know what? I had to be with my hands tied.
Yeah.
And then, you know, For all this time until just recently, about a month ago, that I broke out of that, you know, and they realized by themselves over here that I had to do whatever I had to do, and now I got attorneys, you know, suing her for slandering, for fucking putting my name, you know, and doing all kinds of shit, for fucking mental depression. I mean, I'm fucking taking that bitch to the bank.
Wow, damn, dude, she's that bad? Fuck, dude, man.
What are you talking about, bro? You haven't seen all the garbage and all this shit?
Well,
internet, man.
Here's the thing. I saw some paintings, and some guy's name was on it, but it looked just like your shit.
Yeah.
And I was like, who the fuck is this guy? And I don't remember his last name, but I know that it was like Armand or...
Man, and listen, you know
whatever his name was, but I was like, this guy's trying to rip off Ricky. And I called up Bane. I was like, dude, I gotta call Ricky because this guy's trying to rip his shit off.
Yeah.
And the stuff I saw, is this... Now, I don't know if it's new stuff or old stuff, but this shit, is this shit that he took and swiped from you and put his name on it, or...
That's exactly what he did, because I told, you know, I told Armando, you know, he called me up a few times before the thing blew up and got out of hand, and I told him, listen, if you want to use my fucking name to get exposure and jump over the to get fast fame, guess what? God fucking good luck. Before you existed, I was already in the market, and people know me, and people know the kind of person that I am. That's what I gotta tell you.
Because you know what? Talking shit, I'm like, dude, I gotta find out from you. Dude, you painted, tell me,
man,
you painted,
listen, you know what I
you
did,
painted
man.
All this shit, you painted all this shit, right? You painted it all, right?
Man, of course, and you know what hurt me? You know what fucked me up? That even after I wasn't already working with nobody, that I was working on my own,
right.
I redid. Drew, I did 5 images, and then 2 more. That's a total of 7 for Robert Payne himself.
You reworked them?
You know how he likes to resell originals?
Yeah.
And I never wanted to do that before. At that time, you know, I go to Robert, I go to, you know what, it used to take me 4 to 5 days because of so many things that I had, that I was working on and everything.
Right.
You know what, I'm going to turn this commission, so I'm going to take between 2 and 3 days, okay, to pull this one thing out of here.
Right.
I went ahead and he was very happy. The last illustration that I redid, which it was a remake of Eddie Page and then the Julie Strain, okay, I turned it around in less than 3 days, okay, Federal Express it to him and everything. He sold it for $8,000. Did you think they called me to tell me thank you?
Hell no,
never.
Come on,
never.
We're talking
never,
about,
man.
Come on.
Never. And in a conversation that I had with him just recently, you know, the last time that he returned back my call, I told him, listen, man, how the man, you know, even with all this garbage and all this shit, you know me, and you know you started dealing with me before I was working with anybody to help me out, putting out more originals out there.
Why don't you sue Bane?
Huh?
Why don't you sue Bane?
Oh, man, listen, man, right now I got my attorney that just recently sent a letter, because, it's fucked up, man, because, you know, the attorney for this guy, Moore, which he's a really, 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 really attorney, he's a really good friend with Michael Bayer and Joe Quesada for Marvel.
Right.
You know, he calls me up and says to me, bro, we know you. What the fuck is going on? What is all this shit? You know?
Right.
And I tell him the story, and he goes to me, Ricky, you don't understand. About 2 years ago, this guy from Marvel Comics, and he didn't want to mention any names, he had the same thing happen. His girlfriend posted naked pictures of him on the website, and
shit!
No, it's crazy. He fucking took the shit, you know, he took it to court, she started telling him, and I'll tell you this, you know, the story was between Michael Bayer and Buzz, because you know that they worked, and I would say 80% of feature original, they've worked together, you know, including a lot of stuff, different vampires. Everything and whatnot. That's fine, bro.
Yeah.
That's fine, bro. They're both great artists, man.
Yeah.
That's fine. If they got their relationship like that and they get paid like that and whatever, hey, man, fuck, more power to them.
Yeah.
I fucking know, you know, fucking, I know 2 old finishers that work for Simon Bisley and they never received any credit for anything.
No shit. You know some finishers for Biz?
What, man? Oh, my God. Listen, right here in South Beach, it's just empty. The new Maxim that came out. There's this 70-something-year-old man, and I met him like about a month ago because I was interviewed by Ocean Drive Magazine. And you know whose finisher he was?
Who?
Alberto Vargas.
Who?
Okay, Vargas.
Vargas,
bro.
Dude.
Now, you tell me that he had a finisher, you know, and that nobody ever knew about it and everything. This man is like 70-something-year-old, and he works, you know what he does right now? He does restoration for one of the most popular galleries right here in South.
He's old enough.
But he's been doing restoration for about I don't know how many years there. And nobody knows who the fuck he is.
Yeah, exactly.
And that's fucking sad.
Well, you know, you gotta be a businessman. Most of these artists.
Hey, listen, man. We know it. We were there. We were getting paid when the industry was there.
Right. Well, that's the thing. Because, you know, here's the thing. I don't care because, you know, a fuck business, fuck legal shit, I don't care. But when somebody's telling me, because, you know, I look at you like a fellow artist, you know, you are a fellow artist, and I respect your work a lot, and I was like, when people are talking this shit, and I just want, because I have to know, because I've heard like 5 million people tell me about your work, and I need to know, artist to artist, you painted this shit, man.
Oh my God, I can't believe it. Who told you, man?
Dude, everybody from Bane to the people in this gallery, to the people in comics, to everybody I hear.
I don't give a fuck about the people in his gallery. They're all fucking sharks.
They are.
And guess what? They couldn't, you know, they didn't care after I went ahead and I redid it almost, you know, the last 7 illustrations, and they sold the last one for $8,000, huh?
Right.
You know, I bet they don't say that to anybody.
Yeah, that's true.
Man,
I mean, you know what you're talking about.
I don't give a fuck about none of them. You know, they were happy, and the motherfucker still owes me money right now, and he hasn't fucking sent me any money.
Well, you know,
he replied me back.
He owes me a shitload too, man. They ain't worth my time. You know why? I'm gonna go on. I'm gonna paint some new shit, and you're gonna paint some new shit, and we're gonna keep on going and put this shit behind us and keep on painting.
Hey, listen, man. That's exactly what I've been. That is exactly.
Good, man.
And concentrating in new projects, concentrating in new shit. And one thing that I should have never done, was, you know, just, and you know, and I understand that John, you know, he did it, you know, he did it business-wise, and he convinced me, because he would have never convinced me if the industry would have been doing, you know, as it was doing back then. He convinced me because of the fact that the industry was doing that, and we, you know, we got a family, I got two kids, and I got to feed them, you know?
Hey, I understand that shit. You don't tell me about that.
Exactly. I can't afford to be doing fucking illustrations and selling them, you know, for whatever, and having a hard time trying to fucking pay rent and food and whatever.
Man, you don't want No, but here's the thing. But we're better now. We don't want to just build. We want to get paid. Motherfuckers got to get paid.
Listen, man, just like everybody else that is out there, dude, the problem is that I've had a lot of support from a lot of people, but then again, I've had a lot of people that have turned and talk a lot of shit, and you know why? Because they're not 100% secure about them inside.
Hey, man.
Hypocrites.
Hey, you know what? Just prove them wrong and paint your ass off and fucking put out some new shit and say, you know what? Fuck you in your face, man. That'll put all that shit to rest.
Man, I've created, and the new website that I'm creating right now, there's a reason that I started creating a whole totally complete website, wickedworldwide.com. And the reason that in about another week or so, you're going to see, I redid.
Let me write this down. Well, I want to write it down because I haven't checked out. I want to check out your shit, man. Because
wickedworldwide.com. I redid a number of illustrations. Even better than the actually originals that there were before, just for myself. Not to prove anything to anybody, but just for myself.
You know what? That's what I wanted to hear, because I have to be honest. When I heard all this shit, I was like, fuck, no way. And I was like, no way. And I was just falling over. And then I was like, shit, no way. And then I tried to find your numbers and they were disconnected. And I just finally got it. And I was like, dude, I hope this is it. And I just wanted to hear it.
Where'd you get it from?
Some chick at the gallery.
Oh, yeah? On that rubber band over there?
Yeah. What's her name? That new bitch. She got it for me. I forgot her name.
I have no idea who that is.
Oh, she's pretty cool.
Well, you know what? I don't know her, but Anne and Robert himself and whatever. I mean,
hey, fuck them, dude. That's all of them.
Bro, is that you don't even understand? I could fuck him so bad it would be unbelievable. He owes me. Is that you don't even understand? He's got. Okay, I got a guy. I got a loyal fan that he knows me from way back, and I go to him. You know, he knows everything that was going on. I go to him, listen, you know what? Send an email to Robert Bain, you know, just like asking, hey, I'm interested in some Ricky Carrillo's originals. And
right.
The
yeah, see what he says, see what he says.
Whatever. All right, so he replied back offering all the originals, okay, that I had already done and he already sold before.
Oh, you're shitting me.
I have two more that I have to send out to him. But this is the funny thing. The funny thing is that I have a bitty page that I had just finished done. My fan, you know, my guy, he had just bought it. Bought it for me. I gotta ship it to him, and Rubber Bean is offering it to him for $3,500.
Jesus.
All right. You know,
dude, he's a fucking. He's a snake, dude.
Man, you know, and I have that on emails. I have it saved, and I go to him. You know what, Billy? You know, save this shit because you don't know one day if I'm ever gonna need it. You don't know if one day I'm ever gonna need it. But just so that you know, just so that you understand, you know what? Nobody gives a fuck. You know, and if anybody out there, you know, can cheat on their fucking taxes, guess what? You know, and they're gonna go ahead and they're gonna fucking do it. You know, the bottom line is that, hey, you know what? Business is business, and the rest walks. That's all there is to it.
Yeah,
Bane
was telling me that that new artist guy. What's his fucking last name? What's his
Armando
last name?
Huerta.
Huerta. Yeah, that's it. Yeah. That's it. Yeah. He was telling me that him and some chick. Because I was at the con last year. Did you go last year?
No, I didn't go.
See, I'm going this year to show off some of my new shit. You going this year? I can meet you there. Have some drinks.
I only wish, man. I can't. I can go right now. I gotta. And all this project.
Yeah, no, I hear you, man. I hear you. Sometimes, you know, fuck, that's the way to fly anyway. But anyway, he was saying that he hooked up with some sticker company.
Yeah.
Is that Net Sales? Did he hook up with Net Sales?
No, he hooked up with Sandy from Stickit. Her name of the company is Stickit.com.
Oh.
He hooked up with, you know, she went ahead and she found them in San Diego. You know, he was in San Diego. She found them in San Diego.
No,
they started talking. You know, I understand that he went to her booth and she goes, you know, they started talking and she goes, hold on a second. You used to work for Ricky. And he's like, yeah. You know, I used to work for him. But, you know, the funny thing is this. The funny thing is that, you know, even now at this time, you know, I do feel, even though that now I don't give a fuck because I already, you know, I was too good. And I feel that I was way too fucking good. And the bottom line is this. The bottom line is that, you know, until now, you know, I know that he does not want to be in the situation that she created. He, you know, and I had a few people that have talked to him.
What do you mean? How? You mean?
That have called me and telling me, Ricky, he doesn't like the situation that he created. He's just,
oh, really?
You know, he's just, you know, balls to the wall.
Well,
got him balls to the wall.
So you got friends of this guy.
Yeah.
And they're telling you that this guy...
He doesn't want to be in the situation. He does not want to be in that situation that she created.
Right.
He's regretted it big time, you know. But, you know, they tell me that she, you know, she's got them both to the wall. you know, she's got him fucking bolt to the fucking wall, you know, and,
Are you still friends with her?
She's got him as an exclusive. She's got it living in his house. She's paying all the expenses. She's working there.
Damn.
A fucking slave, man.
Damn. Well, you know, it's find something good. I guess we got to hang on to it. She sounds like a pretty good business person. I mean, she obviously knows something good, you know, hang on to it. But what about,
yeah, but you know what?
What about Cartagena? You still friends with the Cartagena?
Nah, man, he fucked me. He fucked me. Cause
he fucked me too? Carlos
wanted to do the same thing. When I proposed to Carlos, I told Carlos, I said, look, I'm working with Johnny Loa, okay? He was the former publisher from High Impact.
Mm-hmm.
And he wants to bring in a few illustrators so they could be my finishers. And the bottom line is that, hey, you know, let's move it. If you know, I told him, Carlos, how many illustrations are you doing? He said, well, I'm doing between 3 and 4. And I said, look, listen, we can double them. We can double them, okay? Can double them, and John has a pretty good idea who to sell them to,
right.
You know? And Carlos was all for it. He goes to me, man, tell John to write me a proposal and to send it down to me and everything and stuff like that, okay?
Right.
Next thing I know, you know, he's fucking talking to Sandy and
who, Carlos is?
Yeah.
Oh, shit.
Selling them out all kinds of shit, you know? And the thing is that this is a really small world, man.
Yeah.
Everybody knows each other. And
you got that
right.
Away,
man.
You got
people,
that right.
People call me right away, man.
Yeah,
you know?
You're right. So you got the hookup, so see, that's a good thing. It's a small world. I know people that you don't even think I know, bitch.
Yeah.
So then I find out other shit, and, you know, it's like you can't even begin. I'll get from information that person won't even fucking, they might even be the best friend, and I'll get from it.
Yeah. You know, and I'm telling you, man, I was really hurt for a long time. I was very depressed for a while because it was a total, completely spit and slap on my face,
mm-hmm.
You know, and...
I don't blame you.
But you know what? It's a lesson to learn. It's a lesson to learn, and... You know, all you can do is just like now I tell my attorney, hey, you know what? He's a young guy, but he's a shark and a half. This guy is a motherfucker. He's a bad motherfucker. And I told him, you know what? I need somebody like you to be next to me at 24/7. So guess what?
Right.
I gave him 25% of every licensing deal that I ever make.
Jesus,
you know,
dude.
Every single license. Hey, man, right now he just worked out a license with Miramax Films on a licensing deal for Double Impact. And,
yeah, you're
you know,
messing,
and he, you know, and it's going through. No, and you know he.
You need to get that shit down to the Comic Con, man. Too bad. Maybe next year, man. Maybe next year.
Yeah, maybe next year, man. Next year for sure. Next year for sure. This year, I'm just looking at it as, hey, I gotta pick up the pieces. I'm doing new work. I'm doing new illustrations.
Yeah.
You know, I gotta find out exactly what the fuck is gonna happen with Visual Images, this company here. What they're because they started working on new comics. They started fucking sending press releases to Diamond, and we met with Diamond and whatnot. So I gotta see what the fuck is gonna happen with that. So I just got too much shit on my plate right now, man.
Yeah, and you got this website, wickedworldwide.com, going up. When's that gonna be?
That should be up in about another week or so, because we're building it from scratch, friends of mine, and it's gonna be totally, completely kick-ass. So, you know, they gotta do their shit, you know, which is what pays bills, and they're not charging me one dime, you know, they're really close friends of mine, so...
Oh, that's cool, that's way
to
do it.
You know, so, you know, within like another week or 2 weeks or so, you know, they know that I need it up as soon as possible.
Yeah, get it up and fucking defend yourself, man, and show your shit, and say, yo, bitches, look, man, this is what I've done, fuck you, and... check my shit, and you know what, you keep it up, I'm gonna sue your ass.
No, and I already am, she already replied back.
Yeah, you know what, fuck that shit, you know what, you gotta prove to the artists, you gotta prove to the artists out there that are like hearing this shit going, what? Ricky's not the artist. What the fuck? You know, what's
the
actual
truth? But those people that really know me, that, I mean, that have been there, they know.
That's the thing.
Because, I mean, in San Diego 3 years ago, I was doing Airbrush Live right there show. And on Sunday, you know, we gave a lot of stuff away to charity.
Right, right.
You know, and that's been documented, you know. And in the last New York show that I did also, what was it, like about 2 years ago, the last New York show I did the same thing. On Sunday, you know, because I used to do that, you know. I mean, I was doing it live right there, and everything was given away. You know, I had to charge for any piece that I've given away to charity. Never.
Yeah. I saw a piece that you did that was, well, I don't know. Tell me. It was of Marilyn Monroe.
Yeah.
And it was like a black background. It was like total different stuff. It looks like you went off in a different direction or something.
Because that's what this guy wanted. It right, you know where right that is sitting. That's sitting in the cover of a calendar, 1950s calendar.
Oh, okay, so that's he commissioned you for a 50s
that piece. That piece was commissioned. It's the same.
Yeah.
Listen, I just did a new piece right now, which is totally, completely in early 60s looking. You know why? Because I found out that there's a lot of money in advertising for magazines.
Oh, definitely.
Covering up, you know, no tits, no bush, no nothing, and whatnot. Because obviously, you know, pinups and everything.
Yeah.
You know, it's not putting it out there. So, you know, I learned that with Visual Images. They're like, you know, they told me, hey, you need to go other route where the money is on advertising, perfumes,
right.
You know, fucking...
More mainstream.
You know, all kinds of shit. And, you know, and hey, it's there. And that new one that I did, you know, I mean, I did it for this company in New York that this guy's from Visual Images were nice enough to hook me up with. totally, completely different. You know, I mean, I look at it, you know, I really like it.
It was kind of cool. It was kind of, I liked it. It was kind of loose and kind of, you know, it was pretty tight, man.
It's just more mainstream. It's just more mainstream. You know,
that's where the money's at. That's
where the money's at.
Because pin-up art is such a small little niche in the art world.
It really is.
I've seen
if Robert Bain is having a hard time, you know, paying illustrators for money that he owes, and he's supposed to be the godfather of the pinup world.
Man, he got lucky, all right, a long time ago, and he's living off of that, and now he's going down because he's not really that good of a businessman.
Yeah, you know, and so that's scary. What does that show us, man? Drew, what does that show us?
It shows us we don't need a fucking middleman hustler motherfucker, right?
No, and that we have to look and take an advantage of every single option that we could have out there, you know, to do what we got to do and paint. Hey, listen, if I get a call right now from anybody that wants for me to paint in black and white and that's somebody else on whatever, guess what? I'm going to fucking do it.
Yeah, I got to do it.
That's what's going to pay my fucking bills.
Hey, man, we've all had hard times and good times. And when it's hard times, you do whatever the fuck you need to do to get the shit paid and do what you got to do, you know?
That's it, man.
That's called paying your dues as an artist, you know?
That's it, man. Now, if I'm fucking sitting an amount of money collecting royalties every single time,
exactly.
Then I can choose and pick and say, like that commission's
exactly.
not happening to it.
Exactly.
Look, right, it's just a little while ago. I got the licensing manager from Andy Garcia. Okay, the guy, the licensing manager.
No way, Andy Garcia.
Yeah, Andy Garcia, the actor. His name is Johnny, also a Cuban guy. And he's like, man, I found you shit on the internet and this and that. But then I also found out all this stuff and everything, whatnot, you know. And we were talking there forever. Guess what? He gave me the fucking commission. I've never done it. It's a fucking logo of a pinup girl, but in the 50s looking, and they're gonna put it on a motorcycle, on a chopper.
See, that's
for Sturgis coming up now.
That's spring break.
I've never done shit like that, you know.
Right.
But guess what? Hey, you know what? That's going to pay my bills now.
Yeah.
Coming up,
leave
man.
Your options open, man. Leave your options open.
Please, man. Please.
Well, hey, you know what? I got to take off, but I wanted to talk to you about this shit. I wanted to clear the air. And this guy's shit, this Armando guy, this shit that I'm seeing of his, that's his shit? He's really that good, huh?
Yeah, he is. He's very good. I got to tell you, he is very good. He's very good. And it's like somebody that you see some potential now. Bring him into your wing and you work with him 24/7.
Yeah, you groom him. You groom him to be a better artist. So you groomed him to be a better artist, right?
Bro, I can email you the pictures that he first did when we first got him.
Yeah, here, take down my email address. You got a pencil?
Actually, I don't.
Hey,
just got here. Look, take down my email.
Yeah, go ahead. What is it?
Okay, it's Ricky, R-I-K-K-Y.
R-I-K-K-Y or I, okay.
X-T-R-E-M-E, Extreme.
X-T-R-E-M-E. Okay, .com?
.com. I mean, no, I'm sorry. Ricky Shreem at AOL.com.
Okay.
AOL.
At AOL.
.com.
Cool. Good. I'll send you some shit.
RIKKYXTREME at AOL.
RIKKY.
Yeah. RIKKY.
XTREME.
Yeah.
At AOL.com.
Yes.
Cool. All right. Well, I'll send you some shit and then you can send me some shit and then.
Bro, yeah, send you some of the new stuff that I'm working on.
Yeah, send me some of that guy. Yeah,
I'm always online. I got my laptop right next to my desk. I'm always online.
Oh, what are you doing? What are you, chat room and shit or what?
No, man, just getting emails from people left and right, you know, and staying on top of emails in the world that is out there, bro.
Cool. All right. Well, if I hear something good, you know, like we could work together on something, maybe, you know.
Hey, listen, man, and the same I can offer to you, man.
Because you know, so you're the only guy that does computer coloring, also.
Yeah, man. Listen, whatever I can do, man. You know, whatever I can do to offer, I'm here, bro.
All right, man.
All right,
hey,
my brother.
It's good talking to you, man. Take care of yourself.
Great talking to you. You do that, and we'll stay in touch, man.
Okay, sounds good, man. Thanks.
All right, man.
All right,
have
bye.
A good night.
You too. Bye.
Bye, bye.
That guy's mad.